1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 15 to verse 18. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep, for the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, and with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds, to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. Hallelujah. I'm Prophet Ezekiel Melchizedek. I come your way with the words of comfort while we are waiting for our Lord Jesus Christ. Stay tuned. Hallelujah.
The world.
Praise God.
The world.
What I did on the cross. Go and tell the whole world.
We give our life to Jesus, we become his people, then he will save us from our sin. That's the first thing. He will save us from sin. So a Christian, a child of God, must be saved from sin, because sin is the foundation of the world. It's the foundation of the world. Jesus came to lay our foundation, the foundation of righteousness. And when we say sin is the foundation of the world, sin becomes the foundation of the world's problem. Because sin is the seed that produces death, sickness, affliction, pain, agony, disease, curses, sorrow, troubles, pain. That is sin. If you're a child of God, wants to really like, he must allow Jesus to save him from his oppression. Alright, we're still making chapter 1. Verse 22 to 23. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. So the Bible said, a virgin, that's Jesus, the prophet has prophesied about the birth of Christ. He shall be with a child. So this is a savior, but he comes as a child. And he will bring forth a son. And after this shall call his name Emmanuel, which means, being interpreted, God with us. Emmanuel. God is with us. That means, prior to that time, Jesus was born, God was not with us. Were God forsaking people? Were God forsaking people? Meaning, we didn't have God. And God didn't have us. We were not his people, and he was not our God. We were at the mercy of the devil, and the outlaws, the demons, the gods, that our forefathers worship. So Jesus came as a savior, so he could give us access to serve this God. So we will know this God. So we can serve this God. So we can be with this God. But you know, so many people are yet to discover this truth. Now, We come to Ephesians chapter 2, a Savior is born. In Ephesians chapter 2, look at, we're reading from verse 13. Ephesians chapter 2. Alright, let's start from verse 11. Wherefore, remember that ye being in time God, Gentiles and flesh, who are called uncircumcision, by that which is called circumcision in the flesh, made by hands. Let's talk about that. That at that time you were without Christ, being enemies from the commonwealth of Israel, and strangers from the covenants of promise, having the hope and the without God in the world. Imagine that's the state of the world. The world is without Christ. We are aliens. That means we're strangers. We're foreigners. When it comes to the things of God, we're aliens from the commonwealth of Israel. That's God's family. We're not part of it. And strangers from the covenant of promise. So we couldn't claim the promises of God. When God said, in blessing, I bless you, we couldn't claim it. When God said, he sent for his word to heal your diseases, we couldn't claim it. When God said, I will take away diseases from the midst of you, we couldn't claim it. We couldn't say, God, you sent. You send in order to heal me, so Lord, heal me. Because we were without God. And so his promise was not meant for us. And neither could we even have faith to access it, because we didn't have Jesus who would give us that faith. We didn't have faith, the Christian faith. Obviously, the Savior was not ours. Now, when a person is without God, he has no covenant relationship with God. God's promises are said to be covenants of promise. It means that it is a binding agreement between God and humanity. God has promised that he will do this for us, provided we will do this for him. Meaning, God gave us commandments. If we will obey it, then he gave us promises that he will do for us. So as Christians, as children of God, we need to stand up by the truth of Scripture and his God Jesus for ourselves. So the Bible says we were without God. It's painful to be without God. He said, having no hope and without God in the world. Because we were without the Savior, so without God. You remember, Jesus is God bless. He is not just a human being. He is God in actuality. That is how he can be our Savior. Because he is God. He is not an ordinary human being that Satan can mess with. Because Satan took power from a man because of sin. We lost our dominion and authority because of sin. Because we couldn't abstain from sin, so we could not handle power. But God came down himself, and he has nothing to do with sin. So he is the custodian of power. His name is Yeshua HaMashiach. He's the God who saves. Imam means I'm a God who will take people. Provided you are with me, I'm also with you. Since the loving God, who serving God, We worship with God. We build with you, following you. He says, I am with you to the end of the world. He says, I will never leave you. Neither will I forsake you. And God makes himself clear. Hallelujah. We build confidence in this kind of God. He says, I'm with you. I will not leave you. I will not forsake you. Hallelujah. So, the Bible says, at that time, you were without Christ. So without Christ, then he ends by saying, and without God in the world. So meaning, Christ is that God. So without Christ, you are without God. Verse 13, this is the word of the Savior. But now, in Christ Jesus, ye who sometimes were far off are made nigh by the blood of Christ. You know how I say, some time ago, you were very far off, but now, you have been made near by the blood of Christ. That's Yeshua. He died for us and used his blood to pacify God, to cleanse our sins. Then he says, now you can come close to God. He has finished the work with his own blood, the blood of Yeshua. So the Bible says that by that time you were without Christ, being alien from God, people, and strangers from the covenant promise, having no hope but without God. But now, in Christ Jesus, you who sometimes were far off are made nigh by the blood of Christ. Verse 14. For he is our peace, who have made both one, and have broken down the middle wall of partition between us. Between us and God, there was a wall of partition, that is, a wall of division. And Jesus became the peace for man and God. He came to reconcile us to God. So we can have God in our lives. Yes. So now, you and God can be in talking terms. Because you and God were living at loggerheads. Because of sin, man could not approach to his God. When Adam and Eve sinned, the first thing they did, when they heard the voice of God, the Bible tells us, is that they ran to hide themselves. Genesis chapter 3, verse 8 to 10. And he heard the voice of the Lord God walking in the garden in the middle of the day. And Adam and his wife hid themselves in the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. You know, as usual, God was coming to them in the garden. They heard the voice. And God is coming. His voice is, praise the Lord, Adam and Eve. Then they will have responded, hallelujah, God, we are here. This time, because they had sinned, there was strife, enmity, hatred, war between them and God. So, when they heard the voice of God, the Bible says, they run and they hate themselves. He said, God is coming, we know God is serious. So they hid. Hallelujah. That's the life of the sinner who doesn't know Jesus. Anytime you hear from God, they hide. So Jesus brought a message of peace. This is why you hide from God. He said, yes, because I've sinned against him. I don't want to see him again. You will not be happy with me. I'm not happy with you too. because I can't follow you anymore. I want to live my own life. I want to have my own way. Just a sinner. This was so many people. They don't want to hear what about me. And Jesus came in. He brought peace. He said, it's not like that. Even though you're a sinner, God still loves you. He cares for you. He does not condemn you. He didn't come to punish you for your sin. He only came to change your life, to take sin out of you, to deliver you from your sin. Your sin can destroy you. Your sin can kill you. Jesus, He loves you despite the fact that you have sinned. He knows that you have sinned, but He's still calling you. That's the message of preaching. Look at verse 9. And the Lord God called unto Adam and said unto him, where art thou? And he said, I heard a voice without him, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself. So Adam heard God's voice, and because there was no peace between Adam and God, there was no peace between the sinner and God. Now, God did not declare war against sinners, no. No, I do not even be able to walk on this ground. The ground will absorb us. It's the sinner who declared war on God. God did not say, hey, you are sinners, I don't want to see you anywhere near me. No. If it's the sinner who said, I'm a sinner, I'm not going to go anywhere closer to God. They declared a war against God. They didn't want to come to God. So the Savior came. He came in between us and God. And He said, no, it's not like that. The way you think of God is not like that. You think He's a very, very wicked God that He's going to kill you for your sins. He's going to abuse you for your sins. He's going to maltreat you for your sins. And the devil is influencing you to think that God is more wicked. So as a sinner, don't go close to Him. So you already defensive. You are defensive. I'm not coming in. I'm not going to go close to Him. Yes, I know that He's ready to fight me. Because I have sinned against Him. So Adam and his wife, they hid themselves. They don't have anything to do with God. Jesus brought peace. Ephesians chapter 2. We back to Ephesians chapter 2. Now, it says, verse 14. Okay. It says, for He is our peace, who have made both one, and have broken down the middle of competition between us. Jesus is our peace. How did He break the wall of petition, the wall of division? Verse 13. But now, in Christ Jesus, ye who sometimes were far off are made nigh by the blood of Christ. So, it is the blood. The blood. It is the blood. The blood of Christ. That is used to break down the division between man and God. The blood of Jesus. So He uses the blood. He says, we are far by the blood of Jesus, the great peace. Now, look at it.
Hello, precious one. I hope you're blessed by this broadcast. You want to give your life to Jesus Christ for the first time? I want you to pray this prayer of salvation after me. Say, dear Lord Jesus Christ, I confess You as my Lord and my Savior. Forgive my sins and wash me with the blood of Jesus. Write my name in the book of life. I thank You for saving me. in Jesus' name, amen. If you just pray that prayer, I want you to know that you're born again. Now you're a child of God. You live your life in consonance as a born-again Christian. If you are blessed by this broadcast, tell us. Let us know where you're watching. You can also give us a name and prayer request. We are praying for you. Contact +233-240-59-8420. Call or WhatsApp. Email EzekielMelchizedek@gmail.com. God bless you.
Everything. Yes.
Now, breath, 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 breath. Yes, you kill it. He no second. Abraham, and then the Mojan Atim. Atim, Atim, we are sleeping. Atim, we are sleeping. Yes.
Welcome to the deliverance session. You know, Jesus said in Matthew 11:28, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, I will give you rest. And in John 8:36, he said, if the Son therefore shall make you free, you shall be free indeed. Are you tormented? Are you under attack? Are you sick? Are you suffering from injustice, from demonic attacks? Then book a date with the prophet Ezekiel Mekisir every Wednesday at 9 a.m. to noon for the SOS Prophetic and Deliverance Prayer Line at the Salvation Christian Church Worldwide, SCCW, aka Yeshua Artist Ministries, Accra, Ghana. Venue, Salvation House, number 142, at the back of the New Vision Hotel, SCC, Accra, Ghana. For inquiries, contact +233-240-598-430. Call or WhatsApp. Jesus, the great emancipator. Hallelujah. God bless you.
Precious one, you're watching the Yeshua Artist Broadcast. God bless you for watching. We are spreading the gospel to the nations. Matthew 24:14, the Bible says, this gospel shall be preached in all the world for a witness against the nations before the end of the world shall come. Yes, now we want to invite you to support the work of God, sponsor the work of God, be a partner in this broadcast. You can send your tithes, your seeds, your offerings, oh yes, your partnership offerings, and the Lord will bless you. Look at the numbers shown in the screen. You can call the telephone numbers. You can also look at our banking details. I believe that God is going to bless your life. Now, you need to know that the gospel is a fertile soil where you can sow your seed. So God will give you a harvest of righteousness. When you give, the Bible says, it shall come back to you with measure pressed down, shaking together, running over, shall be given unto your bosom. Luke 6:38. And I want you to understand that God has a package of blessings for you as you sponsor this broadcast. God bless you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Psalm 122:1. The Bible says, I was glad when he said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. My name is Prophet Ezekiel Mekisir, Sunday minister of the Salvation Christian Church, also known as the Yeshua Artist Ministry.
You are here.
I want to take this opportunity to invite you to worship us every Sunday from 9 a.m. till noon. The
I worship
and every Wednesday morning is 9 a.m.
I worship
is
you.
Operation Sam.
You are here.
And then
moving
every last Friday of the month is the
PH
night. It's
I worship you. I worship you.